Hi, how are you? I hope you've been very well. I want to discuss the elephant in the room before we get started. This is my living room. The turn of events that landed us here, let me tell you. Originally, I was looking at background design so it didn't look like I was in a mental hospital every time I tried to do my makeup, and so I could have a more interesting background. And then, my desk broke. So while I was going to film this video yesterday, I have no platform in which to set up. So we're on my kitchen counter. This is my living room. And I actually, you can't see the trees in the background. Now you can probably see it if I sit here. Not much, but a little bit. There is some green in the background. So hopefully this livens up my videos just a little bit. And if I like this setup, then I'll just film here from now on. Both my housemates are out for the day because it's a Monday and they have regular day jobs. I, however, start at 6 p.m. today until 2 a.m. tomorrow, which was very last minute and I'm awake. So let's get ready for work while I talk about what I wanted to talk about. I have already prepped and primed my face and done everything. I also have a green tea today. I wanted to make a coffee because, you know, lifestyle, beauty, coffee. But I already had coffee, and since I'm starting at 6 p.m., I will probably make another coffee to take with me. So, yeah, let's get started. Before we do you remember in my last video, if you've seen it, and if you haven't, I upgraded from foundation shades from 1N2 to 2C1 to then 2N1 because we found my correct shade. Except that it was my wrong shade. I am now 3N1 because I have a tan. It's gonna go away soon and I'll still be a 2N1, but for now we're milking it. We're seeing how that goes. So, update, I am a 3N1. And I still have a sample because God, I have to go get the actual foundation. And while I initially thought that this was gonna be too dark, it turns out it isn't. Hence the right foundation shade. All right. Where do we begin? This video is one that I was hesitant, both hesitant and both very aware that I probably should make it. Since this is a lifestyle channel, I found it sometimes difficult to adjust. What do I talk about? What about life can I talk about? I can talk about, you know, work-life balance. I can talk about anything to do with life. We're all doing life. It's the one thing that everyone has in common. And then I looked at my own life and I was like, how can I help myself and others through what I'm already going through? And I don't like to use the word struggle because it implies that I'm having a hard time. Sometimes things just need to be learned. So I'm going to use a different word when it comes to me. I am on a new health journey because while I am very healthy, and I wanted to talk about this in a way that isn't mean to myself in the past, I did it wrong. I did it so wrong. I started listening about a year ago to what my body wants, in the sense that if I ordered a pizza, or if I ordered takeout in general, while it was great and I loved it, my body did not agree with it. I felt bloated, I felt sick, I felt nauseous, and it wasn't the place that I was ordering from because the place never gave me problems before, but now all of a sudden my body was rejecting the food. So, what I decided to do was eat completely clean and start from scratch. Now, I'm Greek, so a lot of our recipes are extremely healthy and start from scratch recipes, so that's what I was doing. And I started to lose weight. I cut out things like bread, things like pasta, things like junk food in general, so no chocolates, no lollies, no ice creams. I substituted everything. So in place of ice cream, I would eat Greek yogurt. In place of chocolate, I convinced myself dark chocolate was delicious until it actually was delicious. In place of lollies, which I never really ate, but I mean, if somebody offered, I wouldn't say no to, I replaced with more fruits, more variety of fruits. And in place of things like chips, and crackers and stuff, I started eating nuts, pistachios, almonds, walnuts, all that good stuff, hazelnuts. I love hazelnuts. But yeah, in that process, I started to lose a sufficient amount of weight. I don't think I mentioned the foundation that I was wearing. It's the same as always. The truck's from down here. I'm much louder. It's the same as always. The Estee Lauder Double Wear Foundation is just in 3 and 1. And my concealer is the NARS Soft Matte Complete Concealer. I almost forgot. In Chantilly. What was I saying? Yeah, I substituted the unhealthy junk food for healthier alternatives that I knew I enjoyed. And I just did it that way to start with. And it started because... Where's my mirror? It started because I was going to a wedding. My best friend was getting married and I wanted to... I think I'm just going to talk over the cars and squeaks of all the tires that happened, because or else we're not going to get this done and we've got things to do. I've got things to do. Anyway, so my best friend was getting married and it was a summer wedding. I wanted to be comfortable. We were wearing slip dresses and I love slip dresses. They're so cool. I wanted to be comfortable in this dress. I didn't want to have to wear any like body fitting things. So I thought, you know what? I can make some adjustments. They're probably for the better. Let's not eat junk food for a while and see what happens. And the truth is, it worked. Turns out junk food is junk food. Who would have thought? Anyway, so I lost weight for the wedding and then I just got into the habit of eating those things. So when I visited my parents, I avoided any kind of chips that they would have had that they offered, because I wasn't craving them anymore. And so I just kept losing weight. But at this point, because I wasn't taking care of myself before, it wasn't yet dangerous. I just kept losing excess weight. Let's call it that, excess weight. Until I felt healthy. The more junk food I wouldn't eat, the healthier I felt and the better I felt. And then I started dancing again more regularly, which was my activity. And then I went to Greece. In Greece, I was already pretty, like, I felt so good about my body. By last summer, when my best friend was getting married, that summer has been my healthiest summer that I've felt in my life, if you can imagine. And I grew up dancing and eating right and everything. But summer 2023, for us, that's December, January, February, 22, 23, was the healthiest and like most confident that I've ever felt. Ever. Then, June, July, 2023, we went to Greece. Now, Greece, if you don't know, is the healthiest nutritional cuisine in the world. So not only, and I will say I was eating gyro and pastries and ice cream almost every day. Not only were we eating out, we were eating ice creams and pastries every day. How did I lose more weight? Greece is walkable. We were walking every day, up and down little cobblestones, pathways, archways. You can walk to the city. We were walking. We did our walking through the islands. We did our walking through Western Greece. We did our walking through Athens. My God, did we do our walking through Athens. And we did a lot of walking in Thessaloniki, which if you've seen my vlogs about Greece, I vlogged the least of Thessaloniki because that's where I'm from and my family was there and we had lots of fun walking everywhere. So I started to lose more weight. I think as a comparison, I'm gonna have to do this so you can see, because this, if this is helpful to you, or if this is gonna, it will get to a point where hopefully it is very helpful. I'm gonna put the comparison here. In this photo was summer 2022-23, where I felt the most confident. In this photo was Greece, June-July 2023. So yes, the angles are different, but I have definitely lost a sufficient amount of weight. Fast forward to when we come back to Australia and I start working the job that I'm working now. So not only have I come back still not craving junk food, but I've come back with already lost weight. Okay, quick pause because I want to make something clear. And I didn't cover this in the video because it just skipped my mind. In both of these photos, I was actually extremely happy with my progress. It's just that in the first one, it was the healthiest I had been at the time, and then as time passed into the second one, that then became the happiest I had been at the time. But in the continuation of the story, you see where it begins to go downhill. I just want to make that clear. Okay, back to the video. I should also mention the places that I used to order food from. I'm using the Laura Mercier Ultra Blur Translucent Loose Setting Powder. I will mention the places that I was ordering food from changed. I no longer, and this is still true now, I no longer order things like, pizzas or Indian food or Thai food or Chinese or Japanese. I don't order any of that anymore because in my mind, my body didn't agree with it. So I just stopped ordering it. I miss it dearly. Let me make that pretty clear. But I just stopped ordering it because I knew that, at least in Australia, the quality of the food isn't going to be like it is from those home countries. I know this because Greek food here, not the quality that it is in Greece. So I started ordering mostly salads from this place. I'll put photos up of the food. It's delicious and it's filling, but it's very low calorie. In comparison to the foods that I was cooking and eating from home, low calorie. I started eating mostly soups because that's what I was craving. It was winter when we came back. So I was mostly on a liquid diet, but in the terms of soups and salads. So lentil soup, chicken soup, this stew, which was peas, carrots, potatoes. It's liquid-based foods and salads. And while I can argue that yes, there's protein in all of these foods, it didn't prepare me for what happened next. Bronzer, Hoola Bronzer by Benefit Cosmetics. This is the same routine. I'm just getting ready for work. In March this year, so 2024, I had already lost weight in Greece and I started losing more weight afterward because of just habit. In March, I got the job that I'm in now. This job is a very physical job. My first week on the job, my first 2 weeks on the job, I was working on the Harbour Bridge. That's a lot of walking back and forward, steps, carrying fixtures, carrying cables, you know, tying things up, getting your body in awkward positions, holding your body in awkward positions, tightening more things up. So that was a very strenuous 2 weeks while I'm on a low calorie or a calorie deficit routine. My second week on that bridge, I got sick. And they warned me too when I started. They said, keep your protein intake high, eat a lot of food. And I heard it and it went in one ear and out the other, whatever. Turns out they knew a thing or two. Anyway, I got sick. And so that weekend I stayed at my parents' house. We went to the doctor and I weighed myself. And I weighed 51 kilos, which, if you go by BMI, I know there's a lot of factors to it, but I've always gone by it. Again, I grew up as a dancer. There was always a strict kind of weight range that I had to be for my safety and for the safety of others and for my growth. So the BMI calculator helps. And I was about 1 or 2 kilos off being underweight. And that's where I am now. Now I'm in a point in my fitness journey where I have to change everything up. I have to eat more carbs. I have to eat more protein. I have to eat more solid foods. I have to eat more times a day. And I have to do weight training, which, God damn, I've been trying to avoid weight training because, again, I dance, I walk, I work a very physical job. But in order to gain that muscle back, I need a strict routine. And if I'm not working every day, which I'm not, and the jobs that I work, sometimes they're more physical than others. So we have finished working on the Harbour Bridge now. And now we're working in other fields, more flat levels. I mean, today we're hanging off a building, but there are other jobs where they're more chill. Or warehouse shifts, for instance, and they're not too physical. So I've begun weight training. The point of this story is when it comes to your weight, it's all very personal, but being underweight is just as scary and dangerous as being overweight. So now I'm on this journey where I've started buying peanut butter, which is something I cut out. And I cut it out because it was that high sugar peanut butter, that one with the yellow lid. And I started buying organic peanut butter because of the protein intake. I started incorporating cottage cheese, sweet potatoes and stuff. You know, more red meat. I've made lentil soup, which is nice, but I have to be eating a lot of it in order for it to, you know, fix the problem. But it's just hard. It's hard when you go from, I don't want to eat this because my body doesn't feel right eating it, to I need to eat this because I'm getting sick. And ultimately, the choices were you either eat 80 cheeseburgers a day until you gain that weight back, or you do it the right way, which is still, in my opinion, a strict diet, because I now have supplement protein drinks that I take to work, and they are like meal replacements, but not for me, because I need to be eating more now. It's a journey for me because I don't know how to do it. I know how to maintain a weight, I know how to lose weight, but to gain it back, very stressful. And I'm someone who used to be a stressful eater, like I used to eat. And now, because this thing I'm stressing about is food, it makes me not know what I'm doing, not wanting to eat the wrong things. But since this channel has, like I said in the beginning, I've started to change things into more lifestyle and beauty as opposed to strictly makeup. And this is a lifestyle thing. This is a new journey that I'm going on to decide what works for my body from the beginning in a way that I've never had to before, in a way that sometimes stresses me out. And I guess I wanted to talk about it for two reasons. One, it might help someone who could be going through something similar. Maybe we can, you know, work through it together. It's always nice to know that somebody else is learning what you're learning at the same time, and just going through it simultaneously. The other reason is there is a lot of advice floating on the internet. Some people, when I ask Reddit or Google protein meals, I get meals that it's a whole lot of recipes that I don't know how to cook. So I can't adapt them into my routine because I wouldn't buy this and this unless I'm making this specific meal. And it's just, what can I make with the ingredients that I have? Adding more protein, I'm also trying to avoid supplements. When I asked the pharmacist, about supplements, I asked, you know, do they work? How do they work? And she said, try and incorporate more protein through food first. Because supplements are for people who, they have to meet a certain quota. Well, they're not for those people, but they help those people out more. People that have to fill a specific sort of quota, like if you're a bodybuilder or you have to go up a weight class in something, and you can't physically eat as much food as you need. So she's like, if you're struggling with weight being underweight, you need to retrain your body to eat those things anyway. So start with that. So I am avoiding supplements for now, knowing that, like, she did say they work, but for my situation, again, every situation is different. And in my case, adding powder to a drink isn't going to increase my calorie intake. So adding rice to my meal is. And I'm someone who eats more of the vegetables than the rice and meat. And now they're just like, yeah, cut down on those vegetables for some meals. So yeah, I wanted to talk about that today. I did want to talk about it yesterday, but again, my table broke. And it does feel like I'm rambling, but these are just the thoughts that I'm having. Like, this all started because I wanted to feel comfortable in my body and it went too far. So I guess, like, it is very easy to, I don't want to say spiral, because I don't feel like I lost control. I just feel like I got too comfortable doing something temporary. I just wanted to be healthier. I think in the meantime, getting into that physical job that I've been in, it helped quicken that process. So I would have still been eating the way that I was eating and not doing as much exercise and not knowing that I was missing out on a whole lot of nutrition. It's scary because I've never been in this position before. So I guess, are you experiencing something like this, or have you experienced something like this? And what did you do? How did you do it? I have discovered protein balls. Those are fun when I go to cafes and I can get a protein ball. That helps. Another thing that I mentioned, I have tried to avoid weight training forever because it's so uncomfortable. All right, so I'm going into, surprise, surprise, the Born This Way Natural Nudes palette, and I'm using the color nude. I am going to work, so if you haven't seen this look before, it's gonna be wild. with a fluffy brush. This one's by Zoeva, but any fluffy brush you have works. And I usually just apply this on top of the entire, like, there's no chill. I normally do this when I use this color anyway, because it's the closest color to my skin tone. It doesn't really matter. I can't really tell if I do it wrong. But usually it's a buffer. Oh, my housemate's back. Usually I use it as a buffer, but when I go to work, it's most of the time the entire thing that I do. But yeah, when it comes to weight training, I've started doing, at the moment, just once a week with little dumbbells, like leg day. I don't really do arms at the moment because we use our arms a lot at work. We're carrying things up. That's core and arms and legs. But in order to rebuild muscle on a routine basis, I've been doing squats. Squats are my absolute least favorite thing to do. Again, like, I come from a background of flexibility and dexterity and agility and balance, and squats to me is just up, down, up, down. It's just so boring. It works, which is why I'm doing it, but God, I just have been trying to avoid it forever. So incorporating that into my routine has been wild as well. I did them yesterday. I did a routine workout yesterday, which I've been trying to do it at least once a week. The weights that I'm using as well, they're not that heavy. I've got 2 4-kilo dumbbells and 1 8-kilo, which for now, like, they're definitely working. I will have to upgrade eventually when I get to do this routine maybe 3 times a week without too much pain in the aftermath. That's when I'll upgrade the weight scale. But for now, I did them yesterday. I decluttered yesterday because my desk broke and I couldn't film, so I had to take advantage of the chance to just clean out everything I didn't need in my room. And that kept my body moving, and it's fine. I have very minimal pain today. I guess something I'm wondering is that something that is interesting to people, to see a journey go from not just workout routines and all that stuff. I wanted to share the journey of, I was borderline underweight, and these are the healthy things that I did to get to a healthy weight. Healthy weight, subjective. Healthy weight for me, for my body, for my goals. For the next shade, I'm gonna go in with Cocoa. I don't know how to pronounce this color. This one here. And I'm just going to do what I normally do with a classic eye. I'm going to take it on a fluffy brush. This one's by Real Techniques. I don't know it because it is old and everything's wiped off it. But I take that on the outer corner and just buff it out. I take it pretty wide out because I don't really mind how dark it gets. I like dark looks, which I've mentioned countless times that I love dark looks. This color isn't too dark. We're not taking it too dark because we're using brown eyeliner, because I have brown eyeliner. Yeah, the workouts that I know, the workouts that I've got memorized in my mind are workouts with flexibility. So if one day along this journey I talk about flexibility training and, I don't know, all that stuff, I can do routines. I can do workout routines and post them and show you how to regain flexibility in your body, in your back, in your shoulders, in your legs, in your hips. Probably teach you how to do the splits even if you've never done them, just based on flexibility alone. That I can do, that I know. But this is new to me. Squats and weight training, it's new to me. Like I said, it's nice when you feel like you're not going through something alone. So I'm putting it out there that this is a journey I'm currently on. And since this is now a lifestyle and beauty channel, the beauty part of it is incorporated. Like, I started to not feel good. I started to be very embarrassed by the fact that I was underweight because it felt like I lost control. Being in control of my weight has always been satisfying to me. Like, yes, I know my body. I know what I need. I know what I can do. I'm not going to talk about our high school years when puberty hit and we started gaining weight that wasn't ours because of certain contraceptive medications. But, you know, for the most part, it's good. It's good when you know you're taking care of your body. Your body takes care of you. And in this case, I wasn't taking care of my body. With a pencil brush, I'm taking the color Truffle. Wow! This color here. And just like every other classic eye that I do, on the absolute depth of that outer V, and I take it a little bit underneath as well. I'm actually going a bit more overboard today because we're talking. God, this is going to be a long video. I'll try to cut out as much of it as I can, but I had a lot to say about workout, about changing my eating habits, about the food that I was eating, even though it was healthy, it was doing me a disservice. The food that I need to be eating, I'll post all of it. I want to share this journey with you because I think it's important. It's important because I see it all the time. People get slandered online for their body shape and their body size. And it's like, healthy, not only is healthy in all shapes and sizes, you can't determine somebody else is healthy. Because I was losing weight. That is conditioned in us to be a great thing. Until it's not. And it's too late by that point because you're weak. You cannot work. I didn't work for those last 2 days because I was sick. So I want to share this journey. I think it's important. And I think we start to normalize the fact that people know what's best for their body. I think we start to normalize the fact that losing weight, while for some people it's important, gaining weight is important for others. And it's something that's not usually talked about. And I love seeing those stories on Instagram, and I don't really use TikTok, but on Instagram and on YouTube where people do transformation journeys from one size to the size they're comfortable with. And that size could be either. It could be gaining weight back the healthy way, or it could be losing weight the healthy way. And I want to make that very clear as well. Like, there is a healthy way to do both, and healthy looks different on everyone. I have already started on this journey. There's a photo that I have that scared me enough, which I actually took the beginning of the week that I got sick. I took this photo here, and I took it because I thought it was funny that they didn't have my size in the high-vis yet. So I was going to work in gym clothes and wearing my high-vis on top of that because it was oversized. But then I got sick 3 days later and I couldn't go to that job. Like, when I was at the beach and everything and on that angle and in that lighting, everything was great. But like, I lost more weight after that. I'm gonna use the 35XO Morphe Natural Flirt palette for my highlighting part. I always do this. This is such a big palette. I need a highlighter. I'm gonna use Come Here Often, which is this color. And I'm gonna take the fluffy brush from before, the one I have by Zoeva, and I pretty much load that up and concentrate it in the inner part of the eye and taper it out and up. And I say this in every video, but if you're new here, welcome. I have a semi-hooded eye. So I like to open up my eyes as much as I can in order to, I don't know, mask that hood, in order to make it look like I do the work that I'm doing in my blending, as opposed to just not. I also wanted to talk about, like, while we're at the end of the makeup. Now, this is going to be a long video. Strap in. Well, yeah, while we're here, the decluttering. Yesterday, when my desk broke and I was like, well, I started to declutter. I decluttered my... So as I was vacuuming, yeah, the leg from my desk came off. I had to haul it downstairs and everything. And I just started decluttering everything. I threw out old clothes that were just too old and torn to donate. And I have a couple beanies that I just want to give away. I bought them, wore them once, and just nothing. And the freedom of decluttering, again, like, I started looking at ways to liven up the background in my videos, and then fate would have it that I'm down here and my background is happening around me anyway. But I don't know. It was so refreshing. It makes me think about getting a beanbag chair so I can do my reading, you know, getting a little plant now that I don't have a desk. I did buy a desk, but it's just made me think a lot about, like, interior design. And I'm renting here, so there's nothing I can do. I can't repaint the walls. I can't tear down a wall to make the space bigger. I can't wait until I can, I don't know, get my own home where I can break it down and build it back up again the way that I want. I just think environment is so important, and I'm so glad that I decluttered. This is the Fenty Fly Liner. Longwear liquid liner, and it's in the color truffle because I bought it and now I'm obsessed with it. I know what you're thinking. Elle, you have a physical job. You said it like 60,000 times. Why are you doing a liquid liner? Is that even? It's pretty even. I'm gonna take an angled brush now and go back into that color truffle just to connect the bottom of that liner with the bottom lash line, because I said it before and I'll say it again. We have hooded eyes. The liner that we do is lower than most, and we need to connect the two. I'm not gonna do the inner liner because I don't have one in brown. That's next on my to buy list. And my mascara. Better than Sex Mascara in chocolate, because I have it now. But yeah, look, all in all, deciding that I like interior design, that I can't wait to get my own place, new goals are happening. New goals are happening because I'm changing my diet routine. I don't like the word diet. I don't know, but it is. Well, at the moment, it's a diet routine. I'm changing my workout schedule. I'm putting more effort in. It feels so good. And I get to buy a yoga mat, which I have my eye on one, and I'm hopefully going to get it soon. It's also making me look at my wardrobe and wanting to revamp my style, and I'm going to do a video about that soon because it came to me this morning. Like, this is what I'm going through now. This is my current lifestyle. Let's do something about that. Maybe it'll help someone. Maybe someone else is going through it too. We can go through it together. We can bond over this. And yeah, it just feels like a very exciting time in my life because it's just growth. Browns, 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 browns. Usually I would go in with the NARS, what is this? The sheer lip gloss that I've been using in Nympho, just to bring color back into my lips because it looks very foundation-y and concealery. But I'm still drinking my green tea. I should eat lunch. I should brush my teeth. So we're gonna do a bit of lip balm for now. And I'm gonna set, that was like zero lip balm. I need a new lip balm too. I'm gonna set everything with the Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Setting Spray because I have work in 5 hours and I'm working till 2 a.m. I just feel like this moment in my lifestyle is a very pivotal point. And I love watching journey videos. I love watching when people start something from scratch and then I follow them on their journey, and it's inspiring to me. And it's like when they've achieved their goal, it's like, okay, first of all, congratulations. Second of all, it's achievable. And third, I want to do something. It's inspiring. So this is my current journey. Maybe when I move out, I'll take you on that journey too. I will. Doi, lifestyle channel. So those were my thoughts for today. This was for the most part, oh my god, I'm out of lip balm. There it is. For the most part, yeah, this was the video I wanted to film yesterday, the decluttering part. That was new. That was bonus content. But it's just like when something like that happens and your desk, my headphones broke too. So I've had to order new headphones. My desk broke, my headphones broke, and instead of filming, I ended up decluttering and realizing that I wanted to set a new goal for myself. So it's always funny how that works out. And in the meantime, when I wanted to change my background is now changed. It feels like it's time for some change. And also I'm cutting my hair in like 2 weeks or 3 weeks. Big changes are coming. This is the time. And you're coming with me. Hope that's okay. Anyway, this is my makeup for work. Later when I brush my hair and I tie it up, I usually tie it up in a Dutch braid. Because I washed it yesterday, it's still kind of curly. So I'll only do half a Dutch braid and let the curls do their thing. It makes me feel really pretty. And that's about it. I'm going to work. This is my going to work makeup look. That's all for today. I hope my rambling was enjoyable. I hope that you stick with me on this journey because I'm excited for what I can achieve. All right, I'm going to go now. I'm going to finish washing and drying my clothes and getting ready for work. I'll see you next week. If you'd like to follow along on this journey, subscribe. I have to put it in. Anyway, I'll see you next week. Mwah.